Hello everyone, my name is Blizzard Gaming Reviews, and in today's video we're actually going to be playing LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. We're doing the walkthrough guides again, we are stopping with the streams, and let's get straight into it. So today we're actually going to be doing, we did this last episode, Bounty Hunter Pursuit, so now we're going to do Discovery on Kamino. Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Chapter 2. Discovery on Kamino. As separatist activity continues to destabilize the galaxy, Obi-Wan Kenobi investigates the attempted assassination of Senator Padme Amidala with his astromech droid R4-P17. The Jedi Knight tracks the source of a poison's dart to the remote world of Kamino. So I'm just gonna stay quiet during the cutscenes, everybody. No! Don't tell me, he didn't die. He's chilling, he's good. Alright, so I remember this level, and this level is actually pretty fun, so. I remember this level as pretty fun, so. So basically, what you want to start off is you want to come over here and you want to turn on the power. That basically allows that door to open over there. Okay, I am going to be doing separate videos for mini kits. That you do not need to go over there. That is for a mini kit, and you do not need to go over there unless you. There's another mini kit. I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be over there as well. So now you're supposed to follow this guy. After you can get some more studs for, not fall off into the water, but collect some of these studs and try to get True Jedi. If you can't, you're always good. You could always just do it later once you do get other red bricks for the times two and all those red bricks. So now you gotta follow this guy, and he's gonna lead you to the door so we could figure out where Jango Fett is. I suggest collecting as many studs as you can. So now you're just going to want to follow this guy. You can go this way as well if you want to turn on these lights, get some more extra studs as well. You're going to need, you can also take there, you can put the broom if you want extra studs for that as well. Also guys, I will be doing mini kit guides for this game, don't worry, so once we do complete, we will be able to do those. Alright, so now, basically what you want to do is you want to go step on all of these. I missed one. Try not to miss one of them, because then you have to restart the whole thing. So basically, there we go. So that's pretty easy. You just have to need to walk around, make sure you hit every single one. And then you're going to want to use the force on this. And it leads to another cutscene. Right, lots of clones over there. You could use these, and then you could, once you actually do use the force on these, you can just break them. These give you a good amount of studs. A lot of studs, actually. So if you want to get True Jedi, I definitely suggest trying to break those. Alright. So now you're gonna want to go over here, and then you're gonna use R4-P17 to access this door here so he can open it. Alright. Let's see. So we're gonna walk in there 1 second, just grab these studs. So, trying to defeat these, basically what you want to do is, if you can, hold your lightsaber like this, and once you do, so you will not be able to die or anything, you basically, you're invincible, if you just hold down the button, and then you could do whatever, you could just use the force. And then you could just use the force. So I did that without dying. If you don't want to really use studs, try not to die, but sometimes you do try, you do die, so it's fine. So do not worry about any of that stuff. That is for a mini kit. Also, once again, you can try to break these to get more studs, and you get a power up ability, which I suggest trying to get once those droids come in. I suggest trying to go get that power. And as you can see, I'm already almost at. Already. Okay, we just reached 2 Jedi already for this level, so that's awesome. And basically, you just want to press the button for that one. You cannot go over here because it's not free play, so do not worry about that. Now you're going to come over here and you're going to follow Jango Fett. He's going to go in there. You can come over here. That is for Minikid. Do not bother with that right now. You could try to use the force on these if you want. So yeah, he's just gonna place some bombs. This part in the level. So basically, if you come back here, you can go over here if you need to get studs and you have not get True Jedi yet. If you want to, you could pick up the mini kit, but right now I'm not going to be getting it because that is going to be for a later video. Alright, so now you're gonna come back over here after you collected those studs. And you're gonna basically try to you wanna set the bombs off and then just run away kind of. Like that, so you don't blow up. You're gonna go like that. This. That one's a little bit trickier jump, but you should be fine with that. Then you come over here. There you go. Okay, should be good with all of those after you have, I guess, juke the bombs out. But, then you can come over here. Obviously, you cannot get up here unless you have a red brick or a gun character. So you can just grab that blue stud over there. Alright, so basically you want to use R1, P14, and you're going to jump off the edge, try to get to the other side. And then you're going to step on this button so Obi-Wan Kenobi can come over. If you want to, you could always turn on the light over here. And I'm gonna check out nothing. So basically, you just use the force on this. So you could try to get up there. I don't think you can. I think you're gonna need, yeah, probably gonna need a Jar Jar or someone that who could jump by. So now you're gonna walk in here. I would suggest coming back here, and before you do, grab this power up here, so you're invincible with any character. And I would suggest going over here and using R1, P14, you want to shut down all of these, then switch to Obi-Wan since he still has the power up. Sadly, his power up went away, but that is okay. Cannot go over here because we're not in free play, and you're just gonna want to do this to patch up the roof, and then you use R4P17. I keep forgetting. Honestly, I just forget his name. I love how Jango Fett's just waiting there for us. Thanks, Jango Fett. Now we're gonna be going into a boss battle. So. So Boba Fett's gonna be controlling the Slave One, and Jango Fett's, you're gonna be fighting Jango Fett. So this is kind of a tricky boss fight, but it's pretty easy. And I just walked off the edge. First, you want to go attack Django. Okay, should be good for the first three hearts. So then, he starts shooting at you. So you can switch to R4Q17 because Boba Fett's not going to shoot at you. And you can just turn on these so Slave won't stop shooting at you if you want to. It's not really necessary. It only distracts him for a bit, so sometimes it's not worth it. Fairly easy boss fight. And then, okay, I missed that one sadly. You're gonna want to use the force and push it back at him. Ooh. Don't know how he's dead, but yeah, he's still alive. And we just got shot. Alright. Use this. There we go. So now he's gonna jump down, and you just basically have to chase him, and this should be easy for me. Boba Fett just saved his life. Nice throw. Nice throw. Luckily, we got True Jedi. That was awesome. Okay, so we did get like 60,000 studs in that. We got another gold brick because we did complete True Jedi. And since I did already complete that level, you would have gotten a gold brick too. So we're going to head back to Mos Eisley Cantina. And so for today, to finish off this video, we're going to be buying Dexter Jetser. And we just did. And, yeah, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, feel free to subscribe and hit the like button. Also, guys, I make tons of videos on LEGO Star Wars and Star Wars videos in general. So if you're into that kind of stuff, feel free to subscribe. Anyways, guys, I'm gonna see you all in the next one. Peace.